The next topic is really interesting for Truant Success, our Truant Success section, that I want to share with you. And I hope that somehow we all learn from this topic. I'm learning as well. The art of achievement. Mastering the seven C's of success in business and life. Isn't that a wonderful topic? I really like this topic because I discovered this is actually a book. I'm going to be honest with you because basically I was so excited about finding this in my research for the topics on Believe That Love. And I know that throughout the ages, plenty of people have written and spoken about success and excellence, right? But leave uncomfortable. They don't get there. They don't get to their goals. They don't know what to do. And sometimes they get desperate and they don't do anything about it. But I found this contemporary philosopher, and he's a popular business speaker, Tom Morris. Look for him, Tom Morris. And he gathered this incredible information for you, this incredible information. Right now, he's in the top number one seller. Okay. And this book is called The Art of Achievement, Mastering the Seven C's of Success in Business and Love. And he shares with us a lot of things that make sense, okay? That makes sense for all of us to not get discouraged about what we want to achieve in our lives, or to at least look for making changes in our lives, okay? So this is what he says, okay? He makes things very clear as far as how to achieve any goal. Okay, from clear conception of what we want to the stubborn consistency in pursuing our vision to a capacity to enjoy the process. How many of us get so stressed out about achieving anything? Money, success, a career, everything. You know, we get so stressed out about it. I include myself in that. By the way, but we have to let go. We have to, like he says here, and I'm going to share with you that seven C's of success. We have to learn to just enjoy the process. Don't get too excited about it. In this book, you'll find quotes of great thinkers, you know, successful people such as Plato, Aristotle, Einstein, and Churchill. The Art of Achievement, I think you're going to enjoy it. But I'm going to share with you what Tom Morris describes as the seven C's of success. Okay, it's so important to really look closely of, you know, if you want to jot down, get a piece of paper, you know, hey, or look for the book, you know, and read it. But if you want something right now that we're going to give you, the seven C's of success, write them down, because I did, and I have them right here in front of me. They're very reliable tools, and I'm sure the book will explain a lot more in detail than what I'm going to explain to you right now, but I'm going to give you the number one C is conception. Okay, conception. What does that mean? Okay, a clear conception of what we want, a vivid vision, a goal strongly that we envision to achieve. Okay, so the first thing that we do is create that conception. According to what I understand from him, we have to have a clear picture of what we want. What is it that we want? Okay, so this is what we have to have, that vivid vision. And that's not easy to achieve, but as long as we practice it, we can do it. Okay, I think this was a quote from Shakespeare. And I really always remember this. If you can imagine it, you can achieve it. The important thing is to imagine it all the time and believe that you can achieve it. That's really the key to it. The second C, here we go with the second C, is confidence. Oh my gosh. So many of us lose confidence along the way because not everything goes our way. Sometimes we lose it. Sometimes we don't get what we want. Sometimes we fail, or the things that we thought were going to work didn't work. And so confidence is one of the you have to build a strong confidence, according to Tom Morris. You have to build a strong confidence that we can attain our goal, that we're not going to lose our goal. On the contrary, we're going to attain it. To build confidence, build competence. We got to build confidence to build competence. So that's really, really important for us to remember. Conception, confidence, and the third one is concentration. Oh my gosh. So many times we don't concentrate. We lose focus. We lose focus of the things that we want to achieve in life. So many things happen along the way and we don't focus. And that has happened to me too. I don't focus. And we have to constantly be, if we get misdirected, we got to come back to our focus. Focus, concentration on what it takes to reach that goal. According to Thomas Morris, that's what you're supposed to be doing. What does it take? What does it take to achieve that goal and focus on it? Concentrate. Concentration. Our fourth is consistency. That's another hard one. Tom Morris. It's another hard one. Consistency. What he says here is a stubborn consistency is pursuing our vision. We have to have a stubborn consistency in pursuing our vision. Okay? The word consistent derives its meaning from the Latin of standing together. That's what he says. Standing together. Okay? Because you know what? Consistency means you got to be consistent with what you're doing, and you have to be consistent in unity with others to create the same pattern, the same following that you're envisioning, and people that can believe in you and be consistent with you. That's what I can kind of get from it. The fifth C is commitment. Oh my goodness, how many times we have had dreams and aspirations and goals and we don't commit. We say, this year I'm going to lose weight, or this year I'm going to open my new business, or this year I am going to be a better person. This year I'm going to be more spiritual or more connected to God, and we lose it and we're not committed. We lose our goal in between. And he says here, commitment, an emotional commitment to the importance of what we are doing. He's saying that our emotional commitment is so important. Emotional, when we talk about emotions, that we have to love and pursue and be committed to what we believe. And I'm telling you, I'm learning too. Character, incredibly enough, this is number six in the seven C's. Number six is character. That's interesting. I would have never thought that character would be one of the C's, but it is, according to Tom Morris and his book. Character, he says here, a good character to guide us and keep us on proper course. It's important to do this. Good character to guide us and keep us in the proper course. It's true. I think character is very important, very, very important. You have to have good character in order for you to do the right thing and be conscious of your decisions and the decisions that you make in whatever goal you may have, whatever goal you may have. And the seventh C is capacity. That's what he says here in his book. Capacity. A capacity to enjoy the process along the way. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful? The capacity to enjoy the process along the way. How many times, it has happened to me. You get excited about a goal and you started it, and then all of a sudden things don't work out the way you want to. Okay? They don't work out the way you want to. And all of a sudden you're shocked and you feel terrible. It says, oh, maybe I shouldn't pursue this. Maybe it's not good for me. Maybe I shouldn't be doing this. This is ridiculous. We don't stop, like he says here, and enjoy it. Enjoy the process. I'm going to keep that in mind, by the way. I'm going to keep that in mind. You know, this probably of the seven C's, this was the strongest for me, because along the way, you have to enjoy it. You have to enjoy the process of everything new that comes your way to achieve that goal that you have in your life. So if your goal is to, I don't know, write a book, enjoy it. Enjoy the process. Enjoy the research. Enjoy talking to people. Enjoy building that book to where you see it finished. Okay? Enjoy the process if you decided that your goal or your aspiration is to look great by the end of the year by losing weight. Enjoy the process. I like that C. That C is beautiful. Capacity. A capacity to enjoy the process along the way. You know, he also implies, you know, and he says that in life, this is what he says, his quote, in this life, we're either getting better or we are getting worse. If we are not growing, we're diminishing. The good should always give way to the better. Otherwise, it will at some point dissipate into the worse. So he says, in essence, the way I capture it is that it really is up to us in the way we look at things, in the way we pursue our dreams and aspirations and goals. But if we don't do anything about it, then we're not doing anything either. So it's important to not diminish what you have in mind to do in life. So that's my recommendation. I'm going to take it at heart. Thank you. Thank you, Tom Morris, and your book, which is fabulous, The Art of Achievement, Mastering the Seven C's of Success in Business and in Life. I hope you look for the book. I think it's very, very important. This is just research that we did. I'm sure there's a lot more there to get from. So I hope you look for that book. It's going to be wonderful to read, I'm sure, because you're going to get a lot more from it than what I was able to share with you at this time. But I just want to say, you know, that you could always look up for us, you know, and you can look at... I want to thank you for being part of believe.love. We share our love with you. And remember to believe in yourself always. See you later.